start? Okay. Welcome, everybody.
Good morning.
To the 4th of July celebration. Happy birthday, America.
Woo!
Today's the 233rd birthday of the United States of America. Right. And once again, we are here with the Granny Peace Brigade. Are you ready? Are we here with Code Pink?
Yay!
Yay!
What other groups are here?
The Great Panthers.
The Great Panthers.
Yay!
The Rainbow Coalition, folks.
Yay!
Leave anyone else out?
Norman Siegel for Public Advocate.
Woo! Brooklyn for Peace.
Yay!
Military families speak out.
Military families.
Say
it.
Yeah.
Say
it. Residents
of Washington Heights.
Yay!
Campaign to stop the false arrests.
Now, it's abusive policing.
All right.
Yeah. Oh.
Thank you. So how many people, by a show of hands, are newcomers to this event? All right. Well, that's good. That's good. We want to grow each year. Each year on the 4th of July, if you're in New York City, join us. We will be here, as the lawyers say, in perpetuity. And when we're not here, some of the younger folk will continue it for us. This is a great tradition, and what we do here collectively, I'll begin it, but this is not a solo act, it's a chorus. And what that means is we read out loud sections of the Declaration of Independence, because independence is crucial. And looking at this group, there are a lot of independent souls here. And thank goodness for that. Independence is not just the revolution that created America. Independence is, to make it a living concept, is when a mayor decides he wants to go for 3 terms instead of 2 terms.
Ask the king! Ask the king! Reclaim democracy!
And the law says 2, but yet they figure out how to change that against the people's will.
Reclaim democracy.
Independence is when the government violates people's rights and trap them, when the government tries to seize people's personal property, their businesses, their homes through eminent domain. And it's important to read the Declaration, the Constitution, the Bill of Rights especially, because it's a living document. It's important to look back at the 233-year history, and there's some wonderful, brilliant concepts, but there's also some bad concepts in here. Why did it take until 1920 for women under the 19th Amendment to have the right to vote? What does that say about sexism in America?
Still living.
And it takes that long? And what about the fact that Native Americans did not count, that African Americans only counted in the Constitution 3/5 of a white person? And why did it take so long until after the Civil War, under the 13th, the 14th, and the 15th Amendment, for African Americans to be equal and have the right to vote? So we have some dark periods in American history, but stuff like the First Amendment, the Fourth Amendment, checks and balances on government, there's some brilliance, I believe, in this document. And I say over and over again, the constitutional system, we should try it sometime. Because if we did, you know, there's a section we'll read about, you can't go to war unless Congress declares war. But yet, since World War II, we've gone to war too many times in too many places where we didn't belong and without the Constitution being adhered to. So what we do for the newcomers is we read various sections of the Declaration of Independence, the Constitution, and the Bill of Rights. And when we're reading a section, we need volunteers. Where's the sign? Here it is. Democracy is not a spectator sport. And in the context of that, reading these documents is not a spectator sport either. So we need people to come up and read a few paragraphs. And finally, when someone's reading a few paragraphs, let them finish. And if you want to add some opinion, some
amendment,
commentary through what is being read, feel free to do that. Under the First Amendment, there is clearly no censorship here. And there are some myths about the Constitution and constitutional rights, and we'll talk about it. We're going to go for about an hour, if you all can stay that long. And then there's some people who are going to picnic on the various grassy areas in this park. So, again, feel free to comment, and sometimes the comments add to the living document, because we're not just looking back, we're looking at where we are on the 4th of July in the year 2009. But before we begin, someone made a request, and I said I thought it was a good one. And what I would like us to do, even though many of us are opposed to the war in Iraq, opposed to the war in Afghanistan, we're aware that there are many people who, in our name, went and fought, died, seriously injured, and still people fighting. We also, with regard to the Rainbow Coalition, know that through the AIDS crisis, there are many people who have died and are suffering too. So let us give a 60-second moment of silence in memory of all the people, as well as any other people who you want to think of for the next 60 seconds. Thank you. And the Iraqi family, yes, too.
I know, it's
a tragic.
They've been murdered.
That's why it's good for commentary.
No.